the entertainer, the entertainer.
Singer-songwriter Geno Clarke was originally born in New York City, but was probably most well known for his hit, The Entertainer.
They've seen you perform in so many plays, but they're not to know you're unhappy today. So they'll never know, go on with the show.
Most people remember him as a singer, but he was also a songwriter for artists including Etta James, David Ruffin, as well as the leader of the Brute record label that had Buddy Smith from Detroit on with his hit, When You Lose the One You Love.
When you lose the one you love, you know it makes you feel so low. And you can't find peace of mind.
Kid Rock's recent song entitled Detroit, Michigan is in fact a rewrite of a song that Geno Clarke himself wrote back in the 60s. I sat down with Geno Clarke's son, Geno, who still lives in Detroit, and Geno and I had a conversation about Geno Clarke's music and his legacy as it remains today.
He was young when he started, so he was about 19, I would say, in that range, 18, 19. He went down to Chicago, because that's where, you know, Chess was, and he used to, before he sung, he used to do a lot of writing for all the Chess performers, you know, like Mitty Collier, Etta James, and David Ruffin. They was, you know, real buddies, you know. David Ruffin, he just wasn't a writer. He was a great singer, you know. Buddy Smith was his first friend when he came to Detroit from New York when he was like 17, 18, and they used to sit over Buddy's house. I mean, my father was on the piano, and you know, Buddy was, you know, doing his thing, and they just sit around. They didn't watch TV or video games or radios, like we do now. All they had was that music, and that what drove them. You know, he was just skilled, talented. It was gift. It was gifted as that. He started writing at the age of 15. Most memories of my father recording was probably when I was 4 years old. He used to sit at the table, write down, be writing his beats and words or whatever. He was good on the piano. He was a pianist. He read the keys for piano, and that's how he, you know, wrote most of his songs. I mean, he wrote songs like his hit, The Wrong Man. He did that. He wrote that on a napkin. You know, most of the songs had, you know, something to do with his life and the things that was happening in his life. The Entertainer, you know, one of his top hits. You could listen to those lyrics and you can tell, you know, he had problems off the stage, but when he was on there, he you know, did his job and made sure, you know, everybody was satisfied and had a smile after they, you know, heard him.
Although Geno Clarke passed away in 1971 after an altercation with his estranged wife, his music still lives on, and his son Geno is going to see to it that the legacy continues.
Oh, well, I like to see, you know, he get full credit, you know, for his work that he done. And, you know, I want to bring his name back and, you know, make sure that his legacy never dies and it's just going to get stronger.
Keep an eye out on this website for Detroit artists, both classic and contemporary. And we'll see you next time.
The entertainer, you made them laugh and you left them feeling glad. You made them cry and you left them feeling sad. They've seen you perform in so many plays, but then